What's up, everybody? This is Frank with Anabolic Outlaws, AO Nutrition, and today's topic is gonna be the 8 women you should stay the fuck away from, all right? I've come up with this list, this is my opinion, but I think you guys will probably agree with some of the stuff I'm saying, all right? Number one, all right, if your girlfriend left her boyfriend for you, I would recommend you get rid of her. But I can tell you right now, I've seen that one go unfold so many times and it never ends well. For the most part, if she's gonna be unfaithful to her ex, right, she's gonna be unfaithful to you or unloyal to you, because believe it or not, guys, you will become that boyfriend she had over time. I know that one sometime might work out, but I can tell you right now, if it was me, I'd be pretty skeptical and just pretty much assume that, you know, the same demise would end up happening to myself that happened to her ex. All right, number two, I would say if she has no girls as friends, that's a very big red flag. Only has guy friends. To me, that tells me she can't hold a relationship with any women, and that's gonna be kind of a problem because it's not normal. And from my experience, from what I've seen, when they have nothing but guy friends, that means bad news for you, okay? She's gonna have a whole lot of guy friends with benefits, and she's gonna have a whole lot of history and miles. It's kind of like that BMW at the used car dealership. You look at it, you're like, it's a BMW, it's awesome. Then you check the odometer, it's got 300,000 miles on it. You don't want that shit, trust me. Stay away from that one. The third one would be if she talks about her ex, okay? And I understand a lot of people out there, you know, when you first start dating somebody, you're always talking about your ex, comparing shit or whatever. My ex did this, my ex an asshole, this, that, the other thing. But if she's talking about her ex, especially in front of other people, like I'd say about 3 to 4 months into the relationship after you guys have been dating for a minute, to me, that's kind of like she's taking a big piss in your face or taking a shit and, you know, wiping her ass and smearing it in your face. Like, she basically doesn't give a shit about the relationship you two have. So she's totally focused on herself. So I would definitely get rid of that one if you've got that going on. To me, that's a big, you know, fuck you. Every time I hear a buddy of mine or someone I'm with and their better halves talking about their ex all the time, I don't hear my ex, I just hear fuck you, whoever that she's dating. So I would get rid of that one. Another one would be her shit doesn't stink. I would say that there's a lot of women out there, especially younger, they feel almost like you're privileged to be with them or that you owe them something because they have a vagina. Believe it or not, there's a lot of women that think this way. And I blame social media, and if you think about it, a lot of thirsty dudes have something to do with it, because whenever they put anything out there, thousands of guys start giving them attention. I can pretty much assume over time, you know, it kind of develops to where they've got this like godlike status. Don't worry, it'll go away once they hit their 40s. You know, when the new generation comes in, it's kind of like that new model of car, you know? I mean, everyone's on that new model of car as soon as it comes out, but then when the new model comes in, everyone forgets about the old one and that shit goes on clearance. But unfortunately, when, you know, they're that new model state, they kind of have the world by the balls, and you can catch some that are, you know, I guess say their shit don't stink, but, you know, over time, you know, it'll go away, you know, as they age. But I would stay away from that one. Another one would be money issues. If she can't get her fucking finances squared away, that's gonna be a problem. And I know a lot of people don't think so, but I can tell you right now, from my experience, if you get married, her money issues are gonna become your money issues real quick. Because what happens is, when she's done spending her money, she's gonna wanna start spending your money. Because the old saying, her money's her money and your money is our money. That when you're thrown up all the time, it can become a major issue, especially in a marriage or a serious relationship, when you're trying to build your credit up, or if you're trying to put money away or something like that. You don't want to end up having some chick blow it all behind your back or constantly have you spending money on bullshit, because it will affect you. When you guys are together, especially when you're married, you know, you're gonna have to share shit. And I can tell you right now, in a marriage, if she takes a shit, you're gonna smell it. So, and vice versa, that's just how it works. So if she's got money issues, they're gonna become your issues real quick. I can tell you right now, it's gonna become annoying. Another thing would be slob. If she's a slob, she leaves shit all over the place, or she's dirty, you know, she doesn't wipe her ass or whatever, that's gonna become an issue. She doesn't brush her fucking teeth, you know, she doesn't clean her ears out, she stinks, shit like that will become an issue. I know a lot of times hot chicks don't usually have that problem, but I can tell you right now, I could not imagine living with somebody like that. It would bother the hell out of me. Even if she left shit all over the house, underwear all over the place. I used to walk in a college dorm room sometimes and I was like, what the fuck? I mean, my dorm room was cleaner than this hoe's dorm room, but I can tell you right now, you know, that would be an issue for me if someone had hygiene issues or just was a complete slob. Another one would be if she's a drunk. Okay, you don't want to deal with women that are drunk because, yeah, they're fun to hang out with and shit for the night, but I can tell you right now, she's going to be drunk without you, and I can tell you right now, she's going to be, you know, doing those same flirtatious things she was doing with you when you met her with other guys. That's a key factor, all right? If she's an alcoholic, she's going to be doing that, you know, whenever she goes out, she's going to be drinking, and alcohol and horny men is not a good recipe for you if you're in a relationship with a woman. I can tell you that right now. There's gonna be issues, and that alcohol will always be the blame thing, and it will always be, oh, well, I wouldn't have done it if I wasn't drunk. Well, I would just alleviate that whole thing altogether and stay the fuck away from women who gotta be drunk every single day or every weekend. And the last one I would go ahead to put the icing on the cake is gonna be strippers. Stay the fuck away from strippers. There's a reason why they're doing that shit. And I'm not saying about someone who used to be a stripper and who decided to change their fucking life. I'm talking about someone who is currently a stripper. Obviously, I mean, yeah, you know, you think about it. I guess there's like that double standard, but if it's me, I'm thinking to myself, why can't you choose something else to earn a living? Obviously, you love attention. And there's other ways to earn an absorbent amount of living without taking your clothes off and grinding all over some dude for 20 bucks or whatever the fuck it is for a lap dance every weekend. I can tell you right now, I would stay away from that one. That one never ends well because guess what, dude? She's not your boyfriend or girlfriend. She's everybody's girlfriend. And you don't want to have to deal with that shit down the road, especially when you develop feelings or you have money invested or, God forbid, you have kids together. I can tell you right now, stay the hell away from strippers. So those are my top 8. I hope you guys are having an awesome, awesome week. Check out our sale. You rock. Late.
Okay. You want to play rough? Okay. No. Say hello to my little friend.